Welcome, Melanie Martinez.
Hello, thank you for having me.
It's so nice to see you. For me, you've been like this Instagram person that just gives me a lot of light.
Oh, I love that.
It's very sweet.
Thank you.
Så til alle dere som ikke har sjekket ut kontoen hennes, gjør det, fordi herregud, for et nydelig sted. I'm just telling people that your Instagram is a beautiful place.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Is this your first time in Norway?
I believe so.
Yeah?
Yeah, I believe so.
And you have this completely sold out show tonight.
I'm very excited. It's gonna be fun.
Yeah, how do you feel about meeting your Norwegian fans?
It's gonna be very exciting. I mean, just traveling outside of the US is always really fun because I feel like people are very open-minded around the world, and I don't know, like the passion and people singing at the top of their lungs, it's like, it's just, it's incredible. I'm very grateful to be able to do this as my job, you know?
Yeah, yeah. I saw some videos from your show in Copenhagen last night.
Yeah.
And the sound was insane.
It's really fun.
Yeah. Wow, your fans, they're loud.
Yeah, they're amazing. They're so magical, honestly. And very creative and very, very intelligent. So I'm very blessed to have such amazing people listening to my music.
Yeah, and the interesting thing is also that, I mean, you have all these hardcore fans and your shows are sold out. But like, some people might not know where you came from.
Yeah.
So where, how did you get all these people to follow you?
I don't honestly know. I don't know. I just put out, you know, I put out Crybaby in 2015, and I directed, you know, 13 music videos, a music video for every song on that album. And then I put out K-12 and made a film to go with it. Mm. So yeah, I don't know. I think people just connect to the music because of the storytelling and, you know, the intention I put into my music is always to like try to write something that will help people heal, because I think music is very therapeutic. So maybe that's why. I don't know.
Yeah, but because is that your like bigger project in all of this?
Say that again?
No, the healing part.
Oh, yeah.
Is that like the real project?
I mean, it's, you know, it's part of it. It's the intention that I put within my music. I always want to make sure that people feel something that's going to help them in some way, shape or form. Mm. Yeah.
But what do you get the most from your fans when you meet them? What do they say to you?
Music has helped change them, you know, for the positive, and help them heal through really difficult situations. So,
mm. But yeah. Does it help you to heal?
Writing music, yes.
Yeah.
That's like my favorite thing in the world. Like, I love performing, but my favorite thing to do is to be home creating music and art, because that's kind of, it's like my form of therapy. Mm. Yeah.
But what are the good parts about touring?
The good parts about touring, one, the ability to be able to perform the songs that I made, you know, that's a big thing. Mm. But also just like meeting people and singing and being in that energy, hearing people, I don't know how to explain it. It's like, it's a share or an exchange of energy, you know, like you're giving them love and they're giving you love, and you're kind of in this really magical bubble of just like really intense energy, you know, I can't explain it. It's just really intense and beautiful.
And that's a really privileged position to be in.
Yes, definitely.
Because I've been thinking about that, like when you have to like do when you in school have to like talk in front of your students, and you feel like nobody wants to listen, if you know what I mean.
Yeah.
And you're just like, okay, please just shut up for 5 minutes and listen to me. And the thing that when artists and fans meet up and you both get this crazy experience.
It's a really beautiful connection, you know, when people listen to music and it shapes their life in some way, shape or form. It's just like when we listen to music and we have albums that really define moments in our life. Like the fact that my music can be that for someone else is a huge thing for me. Like I feel very blessed that that's what I get to do, you know?
Den nydelige stemmen der tilhører Melanie Martinez, som på plass I studio her hos meg på P3 akkurat nå. Music from your album, K-12, which you also made a movie for.
Yes.
Why?
I just wanted to tell the story better, and I feel like the best way to do that is to pair a visual with the lyrics so that people can understand clearly what I'm saying in the music.
Mm.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that there you did a movie as well. But you do like a lot of arts.
Yeah. I like Painting and costume designing and all of it. I like, I don't know, everything. Yeah, all art forms.
And I mentioned your Instagram earlier, mm-hmm. because it brings life to people. But how did you like come about the visual, your visual thing?
Ever since I was a kid, I loved photography. Like, I loved Photoshop and making just like really fun images, you know. I would do things like, I would take pictures with my friends and like Photoshop my friends floating in like a field or something, you know, things like that. So I think it kind of came from that. I wrote music a lot, and then I just thought, how can I pair the two together, you know, having visual and music, and that's kind of what I'm doing now.
Yeah. Yeah. But also like the whole costume thing and your makeup, it's really like it shines through in all of you.
Thank you. Yeah. I don't know. I like, you know, fun, magical stuff. I'm inspired by like a lot of pop surrealism, kind of whimsical art and film. So I like those Dr. Seuss movies like Cat in the Hat and The Grinch, and or like Tim Burton movies like Edward Scissorhands. Yeah.
But is it, I mean, because I was thinking, like, I think it's hard sometimes to like post photos and keep up with the whole thing. Mm-hmm. But how is that for you? Because your feed, it just looks so perfect.
Thank you. I'll do like fun photo shoots, and then I'll kind of save images together. And then, you know, based off what I'm feeling that day, if I decide to post, I'll just post something that I feel like, you know, that's like the, I guess it's expressing the feeling that I feel in that moment, you know? So I have a lot saved on my phone, especially when I go on tour. Yeah. I'll shoot at home before I leave and then save a bunch of them in my drafts. And then when I'm on tour, I'll just like post them.
Yeah.
So I don't know, just fun stuff.
But what else do you do while touring?
I write poetry. I actually like planning things out. So like right now I'm trying to think about, you know, the concept for my third album and the film that I'm going to make with that. So right now I'm just writing a bunch of, you know, song title ideas. And then when I get home, I'm going to start writing and doing all that.
But how is that when you find, like, if you find a title first, mm-hmm. how is the creative process from that and till a finished song?
I will save a bunch of titles, and then when I go into the studio, I'll listen to a bunch of sounds, and then when I find sounds that relate to one of the titles that I have down, I'll pick that title to work with, and then I will try to create a story that fits within that theme of that title, mm-hmm. and yeah, and then it just kind of goes from there. My process is more like melody first, so sometimes I'll just start, if I have like chords, a chord progression down, I'll just start singing melodies if the chords inspire me a lot. Mm. And then once I have melodies that I really like, I'll pair lyrics with them, and then the song just kind of unfolds like that.
Yeah, but I have a question for that. Yeah. Because when you have like the perfect melody, mm-hmm. and then you can't find the perfect words, I mean, the words, they're like 90%, and then you really want to do like the one melody thing, mm-hmm. but you just can't find like the three words to yeah. match it. What do you do? Do you go with 90%, or do you just don't put out the song?
You just keep going. You keep, you know, working on it. If it really means a lot, you know, I think most of the time I can tell if I'm going to use a song, because if I see a strong image with it, like if I can see the music video, for example, while I'm writing it, then I know that I'm probably going to end up, you know, finishing that song. I usually don't even finish songs if I'm not going to use them. I usually will just, I'll know right away. I'll be like, I'm not going to continue this.
No.
So, yeah.
Yeah. Before you go, Melanie, mm-hmm. I have this thing for you.
Okay.
But first, your hair. Mm-hmm. One side is black.
Yes.
The other side is green-ish, going pink,
it's
purple.
It's like a blue, purple to pink kind of thing. It faded, but yeah.
Is this a yin and yang kind of thing?
Yes, definitely. I believe it's very important to balance your yin side, which is going within, focusing on yourself, being more introspective, and also your yang side, which is the energy you put out to the world, you know?
Yeah.
So it's good to have a balance of both.
Yeah, I try to go to yin yoga sometimes. Just
cool.
to
yeah.
like touch down
yeah.
inside.
Yeah. Do you meditate?
Yeah, actually I do.
Yeah.
And I'm really, do you as well?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
How many times did you have to meditate until you actually like felt it working?
I started slowly, like I would do at first you know, I started with 10 minutes and then I slowly over time went to 15. And now I'm at the point where I've been to like meditation, you know, sessions at like different, you know, crystal kind of places in Los Angeles that they like, you know, surround you with crystals and you do this whole like sound bath thing for like an hour. So.
Okay, but you haven't been to Vipassana?
No.
No. Because, like the silent camp thing?
No, okay. Yeah, I don't know what that is.
No, it's like going somewhere for 10 days, not saying a word.
Whoa.
Meditating for 10 days.
10 days.
Yeah.
Not saying a word.
Yeah.
I can't do that.
people, like some people are like experimenting with that here.
Yeah.
There's a camp in Sweden, which people, yeah, where people go to. I'm not that advanced, but many people say it's just like meditation, not for me. And then I have to say, like, I had to do it like 27 times mm-hmm. before I felt something.
Yeah, you feel like you're floating outside of your body. It's really amazing.
Yeah, it was really, really weird. Yeah. And I really enjoyed it, but it took me 27 times.
Yeah, it takes a long time.
To feel anything about it.
Yeah.
Before that, it was 100% annoying for me.
Yeah, it's hard because it's hard to be alone with yourself, you know, and like your thoughts. And that's the point of meditation is to, you know, be comfortable in silence.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And that's something we all should learn.
Definitely. Yeah. For sure.
Okay, so over to something less important. and that is kind of a quiz between yin and yang. Mm-hmm. In this particular case, it's more about a black or white. I wonder, would you pick regular milk or chocolate milk?
Chocolate milk.
Okay.
Yeah.
Brownie or vanilla cake?
Brownie.
Okay. A black or white dress?
A white dress.
Why?
Mm-hmm. I like pastel colors. I don't really wear black unless I'm like in disguise. So, because people, that's like,
okay, that's so
how
that's
you know.
How to find
that
you.
Is, yeah, I wear black when I'm like trying not to be seen. Yeah.
Okay. Working night or day?
Night.
What's up with the day?
I like sleeping in the day. I'm more of a night owl. I like working at night, like creating at night.
Do you go to the studio at night as well?
Yeah.
Or, mm-hmm. Yeah, you do. Okay. Licorice or mints?
Mints. Yeah.
Yeah, they're good.
Yeah.
Black lipstick or white mascara?
I've never actually tried white mascara, but I think it'd be really cool. I've done black lipstick before and I really like it. I haven't worn lipstick in a while though, so I'm going to say white mascara because I want to try that.
Yeah, and it would look good. Like today you have a white eyeliner beneath your blue eyeshadow.
Yeah, so maybe that would work. Yeah,
that would be nice.
I should get some.
Maybe like just on like the tip of your eyelashes.
That would be really cool.
Ooh.
Yeah, thank you for the idea. I'll try it.
If you had to have your hair in one color, would you do black or white hair?
I would say white so that I could dye it a bunch of colors. Like I would do blonde so that I could do just crazy colors.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Last but not least, a polar bear or a grizzly?
Wow, that's a hard one. I say grizzly. I don't know why, but I just learned about, like, I didn't really know how dangerous they were and how, like, scary they were, but someone told me that they could just kill you just by, like, you know, knocking your head with their palm, you know? That's so scary and crazy. I don't know. I pick grizzly. I don't know why, but I just do.
they're both very dangerous.
They're both
dangerous.
Very dangerous, yeah. Very scary.
And really cute.
Yes, they
really
are
scary.
So cute. Yeah.
Oh, that's the worst with the wild animals. But they're really cute to look at, so
yeah,
let's do that.
Yeah.
Melanie, I wish you luck with your show in Oslo tonight.
Thank you so much.
It's sold out, so it's going to be amazing.
Yeah, I'm very excited. It'll be very fun.